Not everyone is a Paul Potts fan.
Opera is a brutal business, much worse than TV talent shows. If he wants to do it, he's up against some of the most competitive people he's ever going to meet.
It's the audience for the fat lady and the bearded lady and the babies with two heads. And the judges, who have themselves, in all probability, never set foot inside an opera house, don't know what an opera means, said, isn't this wonderful? Because compared to the dog that walked backwards, yes it is.
I thought you were absolutely fantastic.
I really think, you know, we've reached almost rock bottom with Paul Potts. I've listened to about a third of his album, and I have to say, I had to switch it off. I really couldn't bear any more of it. I thought it was very, very ugly. Charmless, characterless singing, and it slightly depressed me to think how many copies it had sold.
This is what makes me so cross. The operatic world can be so snobby and so highbrow, and it's completely out of touch with most of this country's needs, entertainment-wise.
Everybody goes, ooh, he must be good because he's an opera singer. He is not an opera singer.
Paul Potts crosses every barrier and comes into the mainstream. He's educating the masses about opera.
Oh, people are always saying that these people like Paul introduce people to opera. They don't introduce people to opera.
Those people should shut up because I'm sure their ticket sales are going through the roof.
They're not going to see a full opera on the stage.
He's bringing it to the masses.
A bit of a plonker. I mean, he must know that. I suppose that's part of his appeal, isn't it?
Nobody else has done that in this country. Nobody else has made it popular. It makes me so cross. I can't stand snobbery.
If you put him up before an audition panel at Covent Garden or La Scala, where people know far more about singing than Simon Cowell does, he wouldn't get past the first round.
I think that everybody is entitled to their opinion. I just love being able to sing. And I'm just truly humbled by the fact that there are people out there that love what I enjoy doing.
It's the night of the Royal Variety performance at the Empire Theatre in Liverpool. And Paul is about to perform for the Queen.
Nighttime sharpens, heightens its sensation. Darkness stirs and wakes imagination. Silence.
Let's be peaceful. Let's settle. Let's settle. Let's get on stage, me.
This is the big night. This is what we've all been waiting for. This is what all that misery slogging up and down the cities of Britain was all about. This is the night of the Royal Variety Show. This is it. This is what we offered. This is the prize. This is the moment Paul Potts sings for the Queen.
My knickers are literally right out of my bottom. Sorry, Mum. They are. I've got those magic... Sorry. Those magic pants on.
This is as big a moment as I've experienced, and it certainly will be his. And I've got a funny feeling, having talked to Simon just now, it's a pretty big moment for him.
Son, don't know where it is.
Words.
Don't worry about it. We'll
no,
get
I need to worry about it. I've got to sing it.
I'm deliberating right now whether I actually go up and see him or not, but I've just been told that he is absolutely petrified. I'm nervous just watching the show now, and I'm not the one who's going to be singing. But this is, you know, what it was all leading up to. You know, he thought he was good enough to perform in front of the royal family, and I am praying at this stage he doesn't bottle it.
I've just set myself up to sing that. You know, it's...
is immense, and I think he knows that, and that's why he's nervous. But nerves and adrenaline can make you give the best performance of your life, and let's hope he can pull that out tonight. That's what I'd like to see.
There's a slightly small problem. We're reading on auto cue. I have no glasses, so I can't see.
Just only the Queen's going to be watching.
We're pros, we'll do it.
Yeah, Piers has been incredibly supportive.
I'll take you through.
I just tell our old friends.
Yeah, right. Good luck.
Thank you.
This is your
Paul,
turn.
Remember, he's more nervous than you are. So
I know.
We're backstage.
Dress, please.
I'm just talking about Amanda's dress. Could have been really bad.
It is really bad. Do you know how much this cost?
It's nerve-wracking, you know? I don't normally get nervous about anything, but feeling a little bit, you know, you cock this one up. The front page news for 20 years.
You can't sing the song. It's as simple as that. You cannot sing Listen Dormer if you're tense. He's got to put things into perspective. This is what he's wanted all of his life, and this is the chance of a lifetime. This is the most important moment of his life.